Let me tell you about other perspectives on personality that are called the humanistic perspectives. They come from an area of psychology called positive psychology. The idea here is that if you think about Freud's approaches, it's all about the nasty things we want to do and how we try to manage those things. That's actually what leads to conflict in the expression of personality. The humanistic approach is much more positive. It's about how positive motivations can be related to the expression of personality. There are two main proponents of these perspectives, Carl Rogers and Abraham Maslow. Rogers thought that personality was a function of the organism, so the person, the self, which is the self-concept, and what he called conditions of worth. Conditions of worth are the expectations or rules that society puts on our behaviour. According to Rogers, the conditions of worth can lead to an inconsistency between people's self-concept, so how they see themselves, and what they are actually like. He thought that personality development will be fully realised in a world where there are no expectations about what people are meant to be like. He idealised a world in which conditions of worth did not exist. Now, an idealised world where there's no social expectancies about what people are supposed to do and be like, I'm not sure how we're ever going to get a world where there's no social expectancies. But Rogers thought that these were the things that were the barriers to positive personality development. Maslow is probably a little bit more well known. He thought positive motivation was important for personality as well. He defined personality as the expression of the tendency to strive for what he calls self-actualisation, which is the idea that people want to fulfil their potential. Now, to achieve their full potential, people had to meet a hierarchy of needs. His needs hierarchy looks like this. You still see this reported in popular news stories about psychology sometimes. The idea is that if our physiological needs are met for food, water, oxygen and rest and so on, we would be motivated by the next tier up, which are our safety needs. The idea is we can't be motivated by self-actualisation unless all of these lower order needs are satisfied first. Now, a criticism for this approach is that the concepts are defined subjectively and so that they're really hard to test. How do you test whether people are motivated by the need for self-actualisation? It's descriptive. It doesn't tell us about the origins or process of personality. Also, Maslow developed these needs hierarchies by hanging out with a bunch of celebrities who clearly have a lot of resources and very little concern about those lower order needs. So it's not surprising maybe they're driven by some of those higher order things. There's no evidence that the average person is driven by those higher order needs and then ultimately have the need for self-actualization.